continue.
Well, active winter weather north of Toronto. It is chilly everywhere, breezy as well, but when that wind goes across the lakes, that's where we get into trouble, and roads are already quite difficult to travel through the Bruce Peninsula, also for parts of Ontario cottage country, from Muskoka through Haliburton and even into the north toward the lakes and Bob Cajun. Snow squall warnings, there are also watches and weather advisories, all saying maybe you shouldn't travel in these locations, not just today, but for the next couple of days, because the wind flow isn't going to change much, and the air is actually going to get even colder. So right now there's one intense band and then several others that are impacting communities near Lake Huron and Georgian Bay. We're also getting some snow flurries the south part of Prince Edward County, and then heavy snow in upstate New York, where Watertown could see 6 feet, 5 to 6 feet by Monday. We're going to get totals that approach a meter here, just around perhaps Severn, over towards Gravenhurst. So we're going to watch all of this very closely over the coming days as that wind continues to pick up the moisture from the unfrozen lakes. -1 currently in Muskoka, and here's your afternoon forecast. It stays dry in Toronto with a high of 1, 3 degrees in Montreal. Everything you need to know about the weekend coming up.
Wicked, fluent.
Over the course of the weekend, the differences between areas north and west of Toronto and the downtown core will become all that much more stark. We have intense snow squalls impacting some communities near Georgian Bay, Lake Huron, and we'll be tracking that throughout the next couple of days. The temperature itself will drop back. This goes for everyone, but in the GTA, -1 later this evening and then -2 overnight tonight. But with that wind, it feels closer to -8. So it's one of those times where you have to maybe go searching for where your parka is, the hat, the gloves, maybe even a scarf if you're venturing out over the next couple of days. It's still +2 in Montreal, but here too is going to get colder as the weekend progresses. -5 in Thunder Bay, -16 now in Winnipeg. Check out Saskatoon. After a morning of -34, it's still -31, and that is without the wind. Thankfully, there isn't much of that wind impacting Saskatchewan. But for us, there is, and that is the concern, the fact that we have the Great Lakes that are still quite warm for this time of year, and now that Arctic air moving across, and its streamers, that we call them, are banding, and the heaviest band will impact areas around Georgian Bay, from Parry Sound into Huntsville, Gravenhurst, Muskoka, and then sinking south into Orillia. So far, Barrie seems to escape the worst of it, Newmarket as well, but what happens Saturday night into Sunday, this starts to shift a little bit further south, and this is when even the rest of the GTA could see some snow. Now, I don't want to neglect Montreal and Eastern Ontario. There will be at times scattered flurries this weekend as well, and then we'll see these bands reorient themselves Sunday night, and Monday morning's commute could be tough coming in from the north side of town. An additional 40 to 70 centimeters of snow, and it will be blowing around as well. So some of those areas will become almost impassable in the coming days. 2 degrees Monday, 1 for Tuesday and Wednesday, and then turning even colder by the end of next week. Now for southern Quebec, we could have a high of -6 on Friday. So that's the real Arctic air. It's still a few days away. Have a great weekend. Candace?
Okay, thanks so much, Anthony, and thank you at home.
Oh boy, it is a winter wonderland in Parry Sound, Ontario. These shots were sent to us by a former Global News cameraman, in fact. Parts of southern Ontario as well are getting heavy snowfall this weekend. So for all those details and what you need to know, let's bring in our chief meteorologist, Anthony Farnell.
That's right, Anthony. The contrast between the bare ground this weekend in cities like Toronto and what could be a meter of snow up to the north and west, that is just incredible to see. And it's all lake effect. This is one of the heavier bands. There may be lightning strikes. There was one or two earlier from Kincardine to Hanover. Snowfall rates of 5 to 8 centimeters per hour. There hasn't been much movement in this band, and it actually extends all the way towards Orangeville and Shelburne as well. We're also concerned about the snow in Bracebridge, where already 40 plus centimeters is on the ground. This band shifting south ever so slightly, and it extends right to the Honey Harbor Midland area. There's also some heavier snow still impacting Parry Sound. As you saw that video, it is a winter wonderland up to the north. So these squalls, along with parts of Prince Edward County and then the New York side of the border for Lake Erie, it is going to be a very white weekend, and these snow squall warnings are going to be in place for much of that time. Also now, weather advisories in this green color that extend all the way to the Ottawa Valley. Long duration, long fetch for these squalls, and you can see why. Winds are gusting now over 50 kilometers per hour. The temperature also cooling down as it goes below freezing tonight. We're expecting to see that snow become lighter and fluffier and blow around, and then through Saturday, not much change. So we'll be keeping an eye on this entire setup as those snow amounts pile up to a meter or more from Severn up through Bracebridge and possibly Huntsville. Your long-range forecast is still ahead.
The head coach of Toronto FC has resigned.
It's a winter wonderland in Parry Sound. These shots were sent to us by a former Global News cameraman. Parts of southern Ontario are getting heavy snowfall this weekend. Let's bring in Kaylee Bedore with more on that. Kaylee.
Thanks, Carrie. And the snow squalls are just getting started. This is going to last over the weekend, so heavy accumulating snow for that region, but also as you head in off of Lake Ontario. So the bulk in that target zone is still sitting stateside, but by Saturday night into Sunday, we are looking to see some of that accumulation, and chance of flurries does linger around the region for tonight. Hovering around that freezing point, we have that gusty wind. Tomorrow, primarily cloud cover, but you can see we have the chance of some flurries and also those squalls setting in. If we start to see this shift slightly north and get caught in on some of this intense kind of snow activity, that's when we'll really start to see some of those higher totals. But I think it is expected to shift slightly by later Saturday. So we'll just keep a close eye on watches and warnings with this one. For now, they are getting absolutely hammered with snow south of the border coming in off of Lake Ontario. So that is going to be the setup that continues. These are going to persist over the weekend, and it's going to be a little bit of back and forth, but we certainly do have the chance of seeing some flurries. And if we start to notice that traveling a little bit farther north, we're looking at about 5 to 10 centimeters for Kingston Saturday, with additional accumulation possible on Sunday. So we're almost right on the edge of where you could see high totals, and then just a kilometer or so away, you may not get too much accumulation at all. But it's going to be cold and it's going to be windy this weekend. More coming up. For now, that's a first look at your weather.
First Weather is brought to you by Aubin Windows and Doors. For premium products, award-winning service, and professional installations, visit aubin.com.
The Kingston Frontenac.
This is brought to you by Kingston Community Credit Union. Align your money with your values. Visit kccu.ca.
Well, time now for a full look at your forecast. Of course, we've been following this story and this setup all week. Snow squalls are now developing. Well, they have been, and they're kind of ramping up across southern Ontario. We're seeing it off of all of the Great Lakes and Georgian Bay. It's going to be the story through the weekend. Travel impacts, dangerous road conditions, and also heavy accumulating snow. More in a moment. For now, temperatures, it is getting cooler. Winds are quite gusty, temperatures are falling, and it's going to be quite cold over the weekend and into next week. Some of the cooler air that's been in place farther west is now making its way to us. So expect that cold air to be in place as it makes its way over the Great Lakes. This is what you get. And we are seeing serious snow squalls developing. Well, one in particular off of Lake Ontario that's really impacting areas on the state side of the border. So we're seeing heavy accumulating snowfall there, but also getting into some blowing snow for portions of Prince Edward County and Kingston. So chance of flurries does continue tonight and blowing snow is possible. And then risk of snow squalls through Saturday and Sunday. If it starts to shift slightly north, that's when we'll be seeing some of that really serious accumulation. But 5 to 10 centimeters is possible by Saturday night in Kingston or Saturday night into the overnight, and then some additional accumulation is possible on Sunday. Now, we're also seeing impacts from the squalls coming in off of Georgian Bay, and they're extending into parts of the region, so still seeing some of those kind of bursts of flurries, and that lingers over the weekend. We've got that gusty wind, it's cold, and it is expected to be cold for the weekend and also next week. Wind gusts will continue for tonight, for tomorrow as well, so expect that to linger. Here's a look at the region a little bit closer. Now, it is possible that we even see some clearing at times. You might get a sunny break, and then you'll notice some blowing snow. There's that snow squall travel and how that is kind of making its way through the region. It lingers a little bit farther south and then makes its way back north. So my advice, just keep an eye on the watches and warnings over the weekend. If you are planning to do any traveling, make sure you look at the route where you're headed, because you do not want to come up on one of these of snow squalls. But some of the heavier accumulating snow does appear to stay south of the border. Minus one for Kingston through the overnight, watching for any slick conditions with some of that precipitation, and then also seeing the temperature dip to freezing. 3 degrees tomorrow, but it's going to be feeling even cooler. Taking a look at the next few days, chance of snow squalls and flurries lingers over the weekend. A bit of a lull with more snow opportunities next week and very cold temperatures by the end of the week. That's your forecast.
It's a winter wonderland in Parry Sound. These shots were sent to us by a former Global News cameraman. Parts of southern Ontario are getting heavy snowfall this weekend. Let's bring in Kaylee Bedore with more on that. Kaylee.
Thanks, Carrie. And the snow squalls are just getting started. This is going to last over the weekend. So heavy accumulating snow for that region, but also as you head in off of Lake Ontario. So the bulk in that target zone is still sitting stateside. But by Saturday night into Sunday, we are looking to see some of that accumulation, and chance of flurries does linger around the region for tonight. Hovering around that freezing point, we have that gusty wind. Tomorrow, primarily cloud cover, but you can see we have the chance of some flurries and also those squalls setting in. If we start to see this shift slightly north and get caught in on some of this intense kind of snow activity, that's when we'll really start to see some of those higher totals. But I think it is expected to shift slightly by later Saturday. So we'll just keep a close eye on watches and warnings with this one. For now, they are getting absolutely hammered with snow south of the border coming in off of Lake Ontario. So that is going to be the setup that continues. These are going to persist over the weekend, and it's going to be a little bit of back and forth, but we certainly do have the chance of seeing some flurries. And if we start to notice that traveling a little bit farther north, we're looking at about 5 to 10 centimeters for Kingston Saturday, with additional accumulation possible on Sunday. So we're almost right on the edge of where you could see high totals, and then just a kilometer or so away, you may not get too much accumulation at all. But it's going to be cold and it's going to be windy this weekend. More coming up. For now, that's a first look at your weather.
First Weather is brought to you by Aubin Windows and Doors. For premium products, award-winning service, and professional installations, visit aubin.com.
The Kingston
Matters is brought to you by Kingston Community Credit Union. Align your money with your values. Visit kccu.ca.
Time now for a full look at your forecast. Of course, we've been following this story and this setup all week. Snow squalls are now developing. Well, they have been, and they're kind of ramping up across southern Ontario. We're seeing it off of all of the Great Lakes and Georgian Bay. It's going to be the story through the weekend. travel impacts, dangerous road conditions, and also heavy accumulating snow. More in a moment. For now, temperatures, it is getting cooler. Winds are quite gusty, temperatures are falling, and it's going to be quite cold over the weekend and into next week. Some of the cooler air that's been in place farther west is now making its way to us. So expect that cold air to be in place as it makes its way over the Great Lakes. This is what you get. And we are seeing serious snow squalls developing. Well, one in particular off of Lake Ontario that's really impacting areas on the state side of the border. So we're seeing heavy accumulating snowfall there, but also getting into some blowing snow for portions of Prince Edward County and Kingston. So chance of flurries does continue tonight, and blowing snow is possible. And then risk of snow squalls through Saturday and Sunday. If it starts to shift slightly north, that's when we'll be seeing some of that really serious accumulation. But 5 to 10 centimeters is possible by Saturday night in Kingston, or Saturday night into the overnight, and then some additional accumulation is possible on Sunday. Now, we're also seeing impacts from the squalls coming in off of Georgian Bay, and they're extending into parts of the region, so still seeing some of those kind of bursts of flurries, and that lingers over the weekend. We've got that gusty wind, it's cold, and it is expected to be cold for the weekend and also next week. Wind gusts will continue for tonight, for tomorrow as well, so expect that to linger. Here's a look at the region a little bit closer. Now, it is possible that we even see some clearing at times. You might get a sunny break, and then you'll notice some blowing snow. There's that snow squall travel and how that is kind of making its way through the region. It lingers a little bit farther south and then makes its way back north. So my advice, just keep an eye on the watches and warnings over the weekend. If you are planning to do any traveling, make sure you look at the route where you're headed, because you do not want to come up on one of these of snow squalls. But some of the heavier accumulating snow does appear to stay south of the border. -1 for Kingston through the overnight. Watching for any slick conditions with some of that precipitation, and then also seeing the temperature dip to freezing. 3 degrees tomorrow, but it's going to be feeling even cooler. Taking a look at the next few days, chance of snow squalls and flurries lingers over the weekend. A bit of a lull with more snow opportunities next week, and very cold temperatures by the end of the week. That's your forecast.
Time now for our first look at the forecast. For that, let's check in with weather specialist Kaylee Bedour. Kaylee.
Well, we continue to monitor the snow squall set up across southern Ontario tonight, seeing some blowing snow, parts of Prince Edward County, and it's kind of skirting Kingston too, so we do still have chance of seeing some flurries. The heaviest snowfall, this squall really has its sights set stateside, so Watertown is getting absolutely pummeled tonight and has been throughout the afternoon. We're not necessarily going to see the heaviest totals in Kingston. It does stay farther south, but something to keep in mind over the weekend, we do have the potential of seeing some flurries and blowing snow. For tonight, temperatures are dropping, and they'll hover around the freezing point into tomorrow morning. Anywhere seeing some moisture as things start to freeze up could be a little bit slick out there, so keep that in mind. Winds also continue over the weekend. But there's a look at that squall. So seeing some blowing snow, Prince Edward County, it does skirt Kingston and then sticks farther south. But we are seeing some flurry activity across portions of the region. Elsewhere, not necessarily going to get into too much accumulation this weekend, but next week too, we have some opportunities for snowfall. But this is going to persist over the coming days. So this is going to be the story as we head into the weekend. It just kind of depends where that target zone is. So we'll take a closer look at some of those totals in your weekend forecast coming up. For now, that's a first look at your weather.
First Weather is brought to you by Aubin Windows and Doors. For premium products, award-winning service, and professional installations, visit aubin.com.
Well, time now for a full look at your forecast. We are, of course, keeping a close eye on any snow squall activities. I think for the most part, we aren't going to bear the brunt of this particular setup. It does appear to be bringing heavier totals stateside. Watertown and anywhere east of Lake Ontario is really getting hit, and they have been. However, Prince Edward County seeing some blowing snow, and then also Kingston still seeing some flurries and still kind of getting in on at least some of that. We're right on the edge. We'll have more in a moment. For now, temperatures, things are getting cooler as colder air that's been impacting western parts of the country starts to shift east, and that's coming in over the Great Lakes, over Georgian Bay, and this is the result, a serious lake effect outbreak on all of the Great Lakes, and we are starting to really see some heavy accumulating snow, especially east of Georgian Bay, where a meter of snowfall is anticipated by the end of the weekend. But here's where you can see the impacts on Lake Ontario. So we are seeing some associated moisture and flurry activity there. Again, not maybe bearing the brunt of it, but still some precipitation over the course of the next few days. And elsewhere also some flurries. So watching for that. And as the snow starts to freeze up, any of that moisture, we are dipping down and hovering around the freezing point this hour. Also gusty winds, and winds continue tonight. Prince Edward County, gusts 50, 60 kilometers per hour. In Kingston, up to 40K. And as we head through Saturday, Sunday, we will notice a similar outlook. Some of that more southern squall does start to shift a little bit farther south. So again, not necessarily going to be worried too much about that. But if we start to notice any winds changing, we could get caught up in that. My advice would just be to keep a close eye on weather alerts over the weekend. But overall, I think we'll miss out on the heavier snowfall totals. But still tonight, some flurries and even some kind of mixed precipitation is possible. So watching for that. And as the temperatures fall, things could get a little bit slick. We'll be down below the freezing point into tomorrow morning. And then daytime highs tomorrow in the low single digits overall. We have some cloud and chance of flurries does kind of linger on and off for Saturday, for Sunday as well. Into next week, some sunshine starts to make its way into the forecast, but also some cooler air, especially by the end of the week, Wednesday, Thursday, another chance for snowfall. That's your forecast.